So I'm Josh Ray. I'm the CEO and founder of Blackwire Labs. OODAcon, to me, is probably the best conference as it relates to emerging technologies and cybersecurity from a content standpoint and from a networking standpoint. You know, I've been in the field for 25 plus years. I know you can't tell by just looking at me, but it's been a little while. But by far, one of the best conferences as it relates to the quality of speakers, quality of folks that come from a networking standpoint. Every year I'm humbled because there's so many smart people that just, you know, I learn something every single time I come here. And it's kind of rare that you're able to do that kind of at an industry conference of this type. So it's a can't miss opportunity for me.
That's great. So the work that you're doing at Blackwire, can you tell us a little bit about the work that you're doing and the kind of challenges that you are helping your customers overcome, particularly in today's evolving threat landscape?
Yeah, that's a great question. So I'd say for the past two decades at least, the industry at large has been really struggling with this notion of a cybersecurity skills deficit. It's actually considered kind of the poverty line of the cybersecurity poverty line, as it's kind of known in the industry. And there's been a lot of tools and a lot of, you know, different capabilities that have been out there that have helped, but nobody's really kind of addressed it head on. So when my co-founders and I, along with Matt, were kind of thinking about, you know, what do we want to do? Like, what are the problems that Blackwire Labs wants to solve? We kind of took that cybersecurity skills, you know, challenge head on, and, you know, it coincided very much with, you know, I wouldn't say the advent of Gen AI, but I would say the commercial use of Gen AI to be able to develop a capability in doing so. So what we've been able to create for our clients and for industry is essentially a cybersecurity advisor, a large language model. And it's not just a cybersecurity model for, you know, the SOC or for, say, a CTO or CISO. It's really a cross-disciplinary capability. So think about it, Amber, as somebody that's got about 10 years of experience and can cross all different disciplines within cybersecurity, supporting your CTO or CISO, all the way down to your security engineer. But in doing so and kind of having to be able to unlock that capability, it kind of led us to some other challenges that we directly had to address, specifically around enterprise adoption for AI. So, you know, we think about the trust component, we think about the data security component, the explainability and the, you know, the proneness of models to hallucinate. So in order to really kind of drive the adoption and to help really kind of address the first problem, we had to address the second problem as well too. And we've kind of developed some unique capabilities around both expertise and trust in order to ensure that, you know, our clients, when they get the output of our platform, Blackwire AI, it's completely trusted, verifiable. You can reference all the outputs, you know, specifically with the sources. And then we've created this technology called Trustwire AI, which immutably stores the knowledge base and the training sets on the blockchain. So when you talk about convergence of these two kind of capabilities, you know, both expertise, the use of AI, cybersecurity, and the blockchain, it's kind of interesting how they've all kind of coalesced, you know, for us here over the development of the last year or so.
Convergence being the theme of the conference today, how do you see these, you know, types of convergence impacting, reshaping industry and the work that you do in the next 3 to 5 years?
Yeah, it's completely transformative. Like, you know, we've seen, you know, use cases where we've had a small health tech company that's down in Florida. You know, we were working with the CTO and he was trying to bring his product to market, just as an example. He's got two or three IT folks, maybe a, you know, one security person on staff. And in order to overcome some of the compliance and regulations things that he had to do from a HIPAA standpoint, he was able to use our platform and basically, you know, saved him about $30,000 in just out of the box consulting fees. So just speed to market in a lot of those instances. But then you take a, you know, state and local organizations, right, which are heavily targeted, very much, you know, in the sights of both cyber criminals and, you know, nation states. And for us to be able to help kind of that state and local, that Fortune 500 to 5,000, is really where we feel that we're called to, you know, support that part of the mission. So when you think about the convergence of AI in cybersecurity, for us, it's, you know, all about kind of two things. One is the expertise, right? You need to have kind of that trusted expertise, that knowledge set that is vetted by kind of a third party set of organizations. So, you know, we've created a cybersecurity community of experts, which is a, you know, an actual organization that vets our training sets, that helps us identify, you know, net new prompts that are interesting, validates the outputs. And then again, as I mentioned before, to be able to use something like the blockchain and ZK proofs and things like that to cryptographically ensure the integrity and the auditability of that data, I think is potentially a game changer, and not just for cybersecurity, but when you think about how can we extend that capability and that technology out to other industries, anybody that really wants to be able to train on trusted data, and for them to be able to provide that direct, you know, line of sight from the output that's being created back to the source material, back to the fact that it's cryptographically secured, I think will help quite a bit with, you know, this notion of explainability and data security that the industry really struggles with. And if we can get that right, at least over the next 2 to 3 years, I think it'll go a long way to, you know, helping to realize the full benefit of things like AI and provide, you know, a viable market for, you know, other blockchain types of technologies as well.
It sounds like you heard some really interesting things today that maybe gave you a lot of food for thought. Are there any kind of key things that stood out to you today, or that you, key takeaways that you're going to take with you and apply to your work?
Yeah, no, every time I come away from this conference with at least, like, you know, 5 or 6 pages of notes, right? But, you know, the things that we spoke about today, one, gave us confidence that we were kind of on the right track, at least with our approach to how we were approaching both, you know, trust and AI, as well as kind of expert data to kind of drive the skills challenge that, you know, has been kind of plaguing our industry for a couple of decades. But I think more specifically, you know, a lot of the conversations around where AI can be used from both a defensive and an offensive standpoint as well, I think is one of those things that, you know, really solidified for me the need to, you know, help these organizations, because, you know, the federal government obviously is going to need this type of capability, but downstream in the supply chain, I think it's really where it's going to be most impactful, especially from a national security standpoint. The only other thing that I would add is really just, you know, a special thank you to both Bob and Matt, you know, for the support that they've given us, you know, kind of incubating at the Hack Factory, being able to, you know, leverage and have access to the OODA network as a kind of a proprietary data source to help us train some of our models. And just that continuous collaboration, friendship, and mentorship has meant a lot to us.